16 hours and a 1500 just to make, you know, whatever it is, $500-$600. If I was a professional poker player, wouldn't be worth it to play those or any of them. So
now that might be a shocking statement to some people that Daniel Negreanu made a couple days ago at the 2019 World Series of Poker. But I would like to briefly talk about why I agree with Daniel and why we know that he's not really a professional poker player anymore. Now, he used to be. I remember back in the late 90s, early 2000s, when he was grinding it out at the Bellagio. Yeah, he was a world-class poker player, professional poker player, grinding it out. But that was before the moneymaker craze. So what happened that made Daniel Negreanu no longer a professional poker player? Well, that would be the endorsements from Poker Stars. I think for the last 12 years, he just got let go by Poker Stars. But for 12 years, he's had a pretty good sponsorship working the advertisements. Yeah, basically he does commercials, sponsorships for a living. That's what he's been doing for the last 12 years and been making a pretty good living, to say the least, no doubt about it. But before we go into how much Daniel Negreanu has made in the last couple years, we're briefly going to talk about that. I forgot something in my last video. In the last video, we talked about where Daniel Negreanu was shaming and berating a player who called him with ace 7 when Daniel had king queen. What I forgot to put in that video was the actual clip that shows Daniel shaming the player. Now, you know, an ambassador to poker should never do that. And even though Daniel Negreanu is no longer a professional poker player, he still does play poker. He has to get those endorsements. And but I just want to show that clip where he shames Aaron Pinson here. And then after I show the clip, then we'll go into how much money Daniel Negreanu has been making for the years 2016 and 2017 when he was still with Poker Stars.
Okay, the guy over here, look, that one's smiling, laughing. He did a dumb, a really dumb thing. Very bad poker he played and knocked me out. What are you doing? Aren't you? He didn't want to win.
Bad parenting.
Bad, what the hell? I'll call. Ready, let's go. What the heck? Silly people sometimes. I'm going to tell you what happened. We busted about 150th place, 155.
Okay, so that was the clip on that. I'm not going to go into it anymore. If you want to know my commentary on that, go see my last video about it's titled Daniel Shaming Poker Player. Okay, so let's go into the numbers. I know most of Daniel Negreanu's 300,000 fans on YouTube have no idea of the reality of a real poker player grinding out a living. So my commentary today, our discussion is that Daniel Negreanu is no longer on the grind, as he admitted. He's no longer a professional poker player. So, and what's the reason for that? It comes down to, for the last 12 years, he was working with Poker Stars as a celebrity endorser. So that's really what Daniel's been for over a decade now, as a celebrity endorser. They put his face out there, and they gave him about $200,000 to $300,000 per month. Yeah, that's our ballpark figure that we're guessing. When you're talking about endorsement package worth $2 to $4 million per year, it probably averages out somewhere around $200,000 to $300,000 per month. Now that's a big chunk of cheese. I mean, you don't have to work. You don't have to grind out poker when you're getting that kind of numbers. I mean, sure, you still have to play in the occasional $10,000 tournaments. You still got to get your face out there at the events and play a little poker, but you're not really grinding it out. Your income was like as doing commercials, advertising, sponsorship, $200,000 to $300,000 per year, per month. But now that's all gone. You see, he's no longer with Poker Stars, and the problem is, the poker games today are a lot tougher than they were the last time Daniel Negreanu was on the grind. So I don't really think that Daniel wants to go back on the grind, especially at his age now. He's a little older. The like I said, the no limit games are a little tougher. quite frankly, it's a tough way to make an easy living. Those sponsorships are a lot nicer, a lot more lucrative, easier. So that's probably why Daniel Negreanu is now investing some time and money into a YouTube vlog. He's trying to get his face back out there and try and snag another sponsorship deal. But okay, let's quickly go into how Daniel's been doing 2016, 2017, just for poker. We know that in 2016, 2017, he was making about $200,000, $300,000 per month for his endorsement plan as a commercials, advertising, blah, blah, blah. But let's talk about how much he made playing poker for those years. Now, he publicly admits in a blog for 2017, the year 2017, that he lost about $86,000. So actually, when it comes down to playing the tournaments for 2017, he lost about $86,000. Really not that bad when you're pulling in a couple million in endorsements. And in 2016, he admitted to losing $1.2 million. Now, these are tournament poker numbers. Now, whether he's telling the truth, I don't know. But in 2016, he admitted online, some blog, that he lost $1.2 million playing poker. So we're just putting this out there, discussing why Daniel would make a comment that he's no longer a professional poker player, because he doesn't have to be. Those endorsements have been doing very well for a lot of these guys. Now, the problem is a lot of these endorsements are gone, and you're going to see a lot of these old poker players like Mike Mattisau and Ferguson. You'll see a bunch of them try to get back in the grind there. Now, we're just guessing. Well, actually, it's not a guess. I think that with Daniel Negreanu putting out this YouTube channel out there, he's also already got 300,000 fans. It's quite natural to think, and it's probably going to be pretty easy, if everything goes smoothly for Daniel, that he's going to snag another endorsement, and then that he'll be able to live off the sponsorship, the endorsement money. He's got his face out there for commercials, and again, he'll be able to play a little bit of poker, but nothing like you see right now. I mean, he's really playing a lot of poker at the 2019 World Series of Poker, but guess what? It's all being bankrolled by online stakes packages, meaning a lot of people invested 500 here, 500 here, so he's really not even investing too much of his money, I don't believe, in these tournaments he's playing now. He's being bankrolled. Online stakes. Now, how long that will last, I don't know. But he's in a transition period. Well, I'll leave you with this. Daniel's in a transition period. No longer with Poker Stars. He's missing out on about $200,000 to $300,000 per month, and he's just trying to figure out how he's going to replace that sponsorship deal. Hopefully, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, that social media triad there. Hopefully that will get him the sponsorship he's looking for. But anyhow, wanted to just throw out a few numbers out there.